What are the diabetic signs and symptoms you must recognize and identify early so that you can be diagnosed correctly as either a type 1, a type 1.5 LADA, or a type 2 diabetic? New research has exposed the exact causes of diabetes. Thus, revolutionary changes in treatment plans can now be realized. The great and exciting news? You can and will improve your health, your life expectancy, and reduce the risk of all these devastating and painful complications once you're on the right path. Understanding these signs and symptoms will help you pinpoint your diagnosis earlier, saving you years of unnecessary pain and misery. But before we begin, let me welcome all of you resilient diabetics out there. This is the channel we turn ordinary, struggling diabetics into, you know it already, extraordinarily well-controlled diabetics. If you don't know who I am and you're brand new to this channel, my name is Jay Sampat, and I am an insulin-dependent diabetic diagnosed a little over 6 years ago. So the proud owner of a pancreas that's gone on a permanent and lifelong vacation. So not only am I diabetic just like you, where we will be walking that walk and talking that talk together, but I do also have a University of Bachelor of Science degree in nutrition dietetics, and that does come in very handy in discussing all the intricacies of being a diabetic. The unique information presented today will only be found here on this channel, The Resilient Diabetic. New, life-changing episodes are released weekly. So if you want to learn more and you want to be notified by YouTube that a new video has been published, then the only way to do that is to first hit that subscribe button, followed by the gray notification bell, then choose turn on all notifications. And of course, if you liked what you've learned today, please smash that like button for me. Before we get into the signs and symptoms of diabetes, we have to know what is diabetes. And based on the newest research, what causes diabetes in the first place? And this new knowledge is revolutionizing the way treatments are prescribed. Diabetes is a metabolic disorder that occurs when blood sugars or glucose levels remain high. This is also known as hyperglycemia. Glucose is one of the fuels the body can use for energy. The pancreas produces a hormone, insulin, that drives glucose from the blood into the cells to be either used directly as energy or, if consumed in excess, to be converted to fats known as triglycerides for future use. These triglycerides are stored in a number of locations depending on one's genes. And this is the bomb drop radical new research has just revealed. The excessive carbs we are eating, both the quote-unquote good ones like whole breads, pasta, even starches like sweet potatoes, and the bad ones like refined carbohydrates and sodas, are being converted into these triglycerides by our livers. They are then can be either stored as fats subcutaneously. This is the fat directly underneath the skin that can be seen. This is the fat that hangs and it actually can be pinched by your fingers. Ironically, this is the healthy way of fat storage and does not cause insulin resistance. Or in the case of type 2 diabetes, these fats are being stored in places it cannot be seen, which is deep inside the liver, within the muscle tissues, and in between all the body organs. These unseen fats deep inside the body then cause what's known as insulin resistance, meaning the insulin the body produces fails at driving glucose into the cells to be used for energy. Thus, glucose then floats around in higher and higher amounts, damaging the body's nerves and small blood vessels from the inside out. In the case of a type 1 diabetic or an LADA type 1.5, which is still technically a type 1 because there is no pancreatic functioning, this is an autoimmune disease where the body's antibodies attack the pancreas. In my case, I got this later in life due to a severe gluten allergy attack where my immune system subsequently killed all my pancreatic beta cells that produce insulin in attempt to protect the whole body. This is also known as latent autoimmune diabetes in adults, or LADA. What we as type 1.5s and type 2s have in common is that our pancreas is failing on us, or in my case, completely failed, but this occurs past the adolescent's teenage years. In the case of type 2s, you have both a pancreas that is burnt out and fats on the inside of the body creating insulin resistance at the same time. These fats are causing even further destruction to the pancreas because it's having to work harder and harder to make more and more insulin. Remember, in type 2 diabetes, years of the pancreatic beta cells having to pump out ever increasing higher and higher amounts of insulin because of the resistance then begins its own demise. It just gets tired and worn out. But another important point to factor in, all this occurs over years, sometimes decades prior to being diagnosed. So by the time of diagnosis, 50% of the beta cell functioning may have already been lost for many, many diabetics. And for many type 2s, it just continues to completely fail over time, turning them into technically a type 1 insulin-dependent diabetic too. So as time progresses and the amounts of blood sugars keep rising and rising, damaging the body organs, the blood vessels, the nervous tissue throughout the body, until the day you actually catch it. So now you know how diabetes occurs. We can now talk about the signs and symptoms which can either come on quickly or take decades to manifest. What are they and what clues are they giving you in terms of what kind of diabetes you could have? And I wish I had this video 6 years ago. It could have saved me years of misdiagnosis along with the pain and anguish that came along with that. For some, the warning signs can be mild so that you don't even notice them. This is especially true for the type 2 diabetics. Some people don't find out they have it until the problems arise from the long-term damage caused by the disease. With type 1 diabetes, the symptoms usually happen quickly, in a matter of days or even weeks. They are much more severe too. In my case, it took several months before I knew something was not right, and then I immediately checked myself into urgent care. That was the day I found out I was a diabetic. But what kind of diabetic was the most important unanswered question to address? Because that is where the healing process begins, with the right treatment for the right diagnosis. So here are the diabetic warning signs and symptoms that both men and women have in common. And I will go into detail on a few of the major signs we all seem to have, and they are all directly related to high blood sugars. The first one is frequent infections such as gum or skin infections. Two could be the darkening of the skin in areas of body creases. That is, patches of dark skin formed in the creases of the neck, the armpit, or the groin. These patches may feel very soft and velvety. Third, breath that has a fruity, sweet, or an acetone odor. Fourth, tingling or numbness in the hands or the feet. Five, slow healing wounds. Six, severe muscle cramps, and these are the violent, painful lockup muscle cramps. And actually, that was one of my very, very first signs. And then seventh, nausea, irritability, and fatigue. Now, those seven I just mentioned could also come from other conditions unrelated to diabetes, but they are tied into the ones I will focus in on now, which are your major warning signs. The first, excessive thirst and hunger followed by frequent urination. The average person usually has to pee between 4 and 7 times in a 24-hour period, but people with uncontrolled diabetes may urinate far, far more. In normal circumstances, the body reabsorbs glucose as it passes through our kidneys. But when blood sugars are high, the kidneys are unable to bring back all that glucose into the body. This causes the body to make more urine, and that takes lots and lots of fluids. The result? You have to go more often because you're peeing so much, and you can get thirsty at the same time. When you drink more, you'll also pee more. It's a vicious circle of thirst and the need to go very, very often. But during this process, all of that glucose passing through the kidneys is continually damaging them. It is literally tearing the kidneys physically apart. This is the reason for dialysis for many uncontrolled diabetics who wait far too long before diagnosis and treatment. Blurred vision is your next early warning sign. As blood sugars are rising, they change fluid levels in the body. The high concentration of glucose just begins to destroy all those little tiny, tiny delicate blood vessels in the eyes, causing the lens of the eyes to swell up. They then change shape, thus focus will eventually be lost. Diabetic neuropathy is your third sign. This is where long-term high blood sugars cause nerve damage. Some people will not have any symptoms, but for others, symptoms may be debilitating. People still unaware of their diabetes may not even know what's causing some of the unusual sensations they're experiencing in their legs, their feet, their toes, their hands, and their arms. These include numbness, tingling, and a burning sensation. Others may experience sudden, sharp, sharp pain that feels like an electrical current. Weight loss or weight gain is another major sign. And this is why you are subscribed to this channel. Weight loss or gain may help you determine what kind of diabetes you may have. In my case, my pancreas was being attacked and it was failing. I was getting hungrier and hungrier, thirstier and thirstier. So I was eating and drinking all day long. I literally could not get enough. But I was losing weight at the same time. Remember, insulin is a storage hormone. Even with all that food and excessive calories, without insulin present, I was losing weight. This brought on nausea, irritability, fatigue, and severe debilitating muscle cramps too. The doctors should have noted that immediately and should have had me tested for both antibodies and my pancreatic insulin production too at the same time. But instead, they just misdiagnosed me as a type 2 diabetic and then sent me out the door with a bag full of oral medications when they should have prescribed me insulin and immediately, because at the time of diagnosis, technically, I was a type 1 diabetic. The pancreas was not producing any insulin at all. In the case of a type 2 diabetic, there may also be weight loss because, as I've said, there are two issues. One is the loss of the pancreas, but the other is the amounts of fats that have been built up inside the body that cannot be seen. And here is why each and every diabetic is unique from one another. Each diabetic has different pancreatic functioning, from still working to not at all. And each diabetic will have different amounts of these toxic fats stored inside the body. So your response to each required medication will be different based on your specific body. Some of the best doctors do not actually like defining diabetes in types. These are the ones who are up to date on the best tests, the treatment plans, and they know how to implement a low carbohydrate diet program. They see diabetes as a spectrum. For example, there are type 1 children who still produce small amounts of insulin, and they are type 2 adults who produce no insulin at all, and they require insulin to stay alive because their pancreas is burnt out and has just failed. This is why, again, one size does not fit all when it comes to the world of diabetes. Once one realizes the signs and symptoms of diabetes, you must be then correctly diagnosed as a diabetic. The next most critical question you're gonna ask yourself is, how long can you live with diabetes? What is the life expectancy of a type 1, a type 2, or even a type 1.5 LADA diabetic such as myself? In the video, how long can you live with diabetes, I will expose some of the hardened realities, along with some great news. You actually can outlive your non-diabetic peers, provided you are aware of the main factors that influence your health. And what are they? One, how fast and accurately have you been diagnosed? Two, your doctor's overall view on the A1C and their ability to tailor your treatment to your specific diagnosis. And third, and most importantly, how promptly you execute on the correct diet plan. And what is the correct diet plan? If you're on your desktop or laptop, use that mouse to click that box. If you're on your mobile device, tap that with your fingers. The first is the link to subscribe to this all-important life-changing channel. The second is the link to the playlist I will create for you with a video just mentioned and many, many more related to your health as a diabetic. So, have a great and productive day, and we'll see you soon with another new episode, which I said are always released weekly. Bye for now.